Thank you. Good evening and welcome. My name is Dr. Paul Haar, the Director of Jazz Studies here at the Glenn Korff School of Music. On behalf of our students, faculty, and staff, I'd like to welcome you to the kickoff concert of our 2017-2018 jazz season. Tonight is a bit more unusual as far as our, yes, it's great because we have a new jazz season underway, but tonight marks the 50th anniversary of the jazz ensembles being an official part of the curriculum here at the Glenn Korff School of Music. It was in 1967 that a young faculty member by the name of Denny Schneider officially took over the lab band, and it became an official marked and enrollable course at the School of Music. Prior to that, the jazz ensembles were part of the Phi Mu Alpha Sinfonia musical fraternity, and it might be a little odd to hear today, at one point in time, jazz was not welcome in the hallways of our music building because it was improper music. So look at how far we've come. I want to extend a thanks to all those hundreds of students who have participated in the jazz bands, and to the wonderful directors, of course, Denny, Rusty White, Dave Sharp, Tom Larson, Peter Buffard, Randy Snyder, Bob Kruger, and Dr. Eric Richards, who have all taken turns. So we want to welcome you. Our theme for this entire year is Yesterday, Today, and Tomorrow, which we're going to play tonight, music that you would have heard in this hall over the years. So without further ado, please welcome to the stage, under the direction of Andrew Janak, the UNL Big Band.
One, two, three. Hi, everyone. Thanks for coming out tonight. This is the UNL Big Band. The first tune you heard was an original composition by the late director of jazz studies at Lawrence University in Wisconsin, Fred Sturm. Fred was a legend in jazz education, an incredible jazz pedagogue and composer-arranger, and Aim High is one of his best-known compositions. For this concert, you're going to hear a wide variety of music. I have the pleasure of working with some great colleagues here at GTA, so I want to introduce Mr. Mitch Dunham on this next song. He's going to be the conductor for our next piece. So here's Mitch.
All right, thank you, Andrew. We're going to continue this program on with a tune by George Gershwin, arranged by George Stone. George Stone was a well-known composer in the LA area for a number of years. He's now teaching in the area there. He actually came a couple years ago and was a guest artist with the UNL Big Band and UNL Jazz Orchestra. So we're going to continue on with They Can't Take That Away From Me.
Thank you.
the next tune on the program we're going to do is a composition originally by jazz bassist Oscar Pettiford entitled Trichotism. And this arrangement is by Dr. Jack Cooper. He's director of jazz studies at the University of Memphis. Also was a head arranger for the Army Jazz Nights for a while. Great saxophonist and arranger. And this tune is a little different than most big band charts because this is a double bass feature. And we're going to feature Mr. Michael Kraft on the bass on this one throughout. And actually, we've just changed personnel. We have two wonderful bassists in this band. So we just had Jonah Bennett on stage, and now we have Michael. And I'm going to give them a round of applause because they're great. So on this, we'll hear from Michael on the bass, and then we'll also hear a trombone solo from Austin Lagenza, and this is Trichotism. Before we play our last tune of this set, I just wanted to thank a couple people. On lead trumpet tonight, we have a UNL alum and one of Lincoln's finest trumpet players, Mr. Matt Boring, playing lead for us. On piano, it's a UNL grad student, Mr. Chris Leach. You may recognize him usually with the trombone in his hand, but he's also a very, very gifted jazz pianist, and he's playing piano. And you'll actually hear a little bit of that on this next piece, but big thanks to Chris. After this, there'll be just a short couple minutes as we change personnel, and then the UNL Jazz Orchestra will kick off their part. Please stick around. And here's Mitch Dunham conducting Invitation.
How about a hand for Josh Peltz on piano? Mitch Denham on trumpet. Noah Goodwin on alto saxophone. And fulfilling the role of Buddy Rich, Andrew Ray on drums. So that was the classic Buddy Rich tune entitled Big Swing Face from 1967, our first year of being official at the university. So we're 50 years old. Our jazz ensembles are now eligible for AARP and at participating IHOP restaurants, senior citizen discounts. So our jazz band concerts will now be at 4 o'clock. No, I'm just kidding. I can't joke about that anymore because I think I'm getting my card here pretty soon. Oddly enough, we chose that song. This year would have marked Buddy's 100th birthday. So in honor, we're firing the entire band. No, some of you have heard the tape. Okay, great. No, this is really a pleasure. We're going to play some pieces that are throughout the history of the jazz band. The next piece that we're going to play is from the great Bob Mintzer band. In the 1980s, Bob Mintzer's big band really brought the modern big band kind of out of retirement. It kind of hit its stride in the 1970s with Toshiko Akiyoshi and the Mel Lewis, Thad Jones big band. Well, he brought a new flair to it, and this is going to feature Chris Leach on trombone and Malachi Million on guitar. This is called Acha.
Thank you.
In 1991, an English trumpet player by the name of Kenny Wheeler produced an album that most modern jazz fans didn't really know much about Kenny Wheeler. And he did it for a rather obscure label to most mainstream jazz fans, and that is the ECM jazz label. What made the recording unique was it was a big band album with the likes of Dave Holland and Peter Erskine and a whole bunch of English jazz musicians most of us had never heard of. I was in college at the time, and I remember going to a CD shop with my jazz director who found this recording and then proceeded to jump up and down triumphantly saying, "I got it and you didn't." He was a rather mature director. And I thought, okay, so what? And then we went back to his office and he put it on. The album was titled Music for Large Ensemble by Kenny Wheeler. And on it was a multi-movement, I think it was in 7 or 8 movements called the Sweet Time Suite. We're gonna redo 3 of those movements. And this is truly one of the most, it's one of my desert island picks. And so I wanted to do this with this great group. And we're gonna welcome to the stage on vocals, Abigail Seidel, and Dr. Greg Simon playing the part of Kenny Wheeler.
children, a splinter of light, breaking apart the dreams of the night. Into waking she comes with the dreams of her heels. That's no time for reflection, the turning of wheels within wheels. Life propels her and somehow conceals, and no one knows how she feels. Gently she smiles as she pins up her hair. Life's never easy, life's never fair. Though her smile hints at sadness, it echoes with fun. Says she'll stay on the path that she feels is the one that will weave its way into the dreams she has spun. Find her a place in the
Miss Abigail Seidel, Dr. Greg Simon, Andrew Janak, Chris Leach. How about another round of applause for Dr. Greg Simon and Abigail Seidel? We're very fortunate. We're going to actually do a Nebraska premiere tonight by our baritone saxophonist, Runkin Lee, who comes to us from Washington State University via New York and China. So this is his piece. Is going to feature Andrew Janak on tenor saxophone and Hunter Young on trumpet. This is entitled Celebrating Chinese New Year in New York. But Andrew Janak on tenor saxophone, Hunter Young on trumpet, and our composer, Mr. Runkin Lee. You know, this is really special to have an opportunity to conduct this ensemble at a very historic time. I was just thinking, this is probably about the only exercise that I get, and I really don't do anything because they're kind of on autopilot. It's really great. So I hope you forgive my horrible dancing. We're going to take a breather for a minute just to tell you about some wonderful things that are going to happen. In a couple weeks, we're going to welcome the Faculty Jazz Rhythm Section and New York-based alto saxophonist Lauren Stillman will be here. So be looking for information about that. This is going to be a free concert, thanks to the generosity of Chateau Development. Lauren is one of the premier alto saxophonists, jazz alto players in the world. And to have that type of talent here. Oddly enough, I first met Lauren when he was 16 at Tanglewood, when he thought he wanted to be a classical saxophonist. And we went back to his dorm room and played some play-alongs, and I thought I sounded pretty good. I was a graduate student, and I listened to him play. He had just turned 16, in fact. He wanted to drive to the Berkshire Mountains, but his mother wouldn't let him. And he played a solo, and I stopped, and I said, "Why do you want to be a classical saxophonist?" He goes, "Well, my teacher really wants me to be in jazz." And I said, "Who's that?" And his teacher was the great Joe Lovano, the amazing Grammy Award-winning jazz saxophonist. I said, So when I told him, I said, "Do you remember that time we spent in the Berkshire Mountains being beaten up by a classical saxophonist?" He goes, "Sure, I'll come to Nebraska." So he's coming, and how could it get any worse, right? So you're definitely going to want to see that. We're also very fortunate that in January, we were notified, August? Something like that. We have an international conference for jazz called the Jazz Education Network Conference, which will be held in Dallas. And the UNL JO was selected to perform at that conference, so we will perform the first week of January. So how about giving them a round of applause for that? We're very blessed that we're going to get a chance to perform there and actually do a couple of numbers with the great Dr. Victor Lewis. I can't mess that up. But we also want to, well, you can't. We went to a lot of hoopla. You might have heard about it. Yeah, okay. But I want to take a moment now to, we're very fortunate. You know, we would go nowhere without our friends. And I want to thank two wonderful people who have really been friends and patrons of the program. If I could ask John and Lori Tavlin to please stand for just a second. We have been very fortunate to be the recipient of their generosity. Kyle Granville is the recipient of the Nebraska Diamond John and Lori Tavlin Fellow in Jazz Trumpet. And new this year are the Nebraska Diamond John and Lori Tavlin Excellence in Jazz Performance Fund, of which we have four recipients on stage. If you'll stand, William White on trombone, Liam Hughes, Andrew Ray, and Noah Goodwin. We have kind of something very unique. How many of you are fans of big band, classic big band music, like from the swing era? Okay. The third Friday of the month, we have a very unique ensemble in this city that is, you know, you've heard stories about, well, this is a professional ensemble, we don't have any students playing our band. Well, this ensemble tells the professionals, we don't have any pros in this band, we have students. And it's actually dedicated to students, faculty and alumni of the band, a group called the Johnny Manhattan Orchestra. And it features classic big band music from the swing era. And the third Friday of the month, we're at the Delray Ballroom. So if you want to check that out, I've been waiting all day to say this. Tell them Johnny Manhattan sent you. For those of you, if you don't know the joke, you have to come to the Delray and check it out. It's really great. All right, is the blood back to where it needs to be? Okay, great. One of the first round of guest artists that I brought here when I came was a brilliant jazz pianist from Knoxville that I had the pleasure of teaching with, a man by the name of Donald Brown. This next selection is going to feature Andrew Janak on tenor saxophone and Josh Peltz on piano. This was written by arranged by a friend of mine, a wonderful trumpet player who runs the Knoxville Jazz Orchestra. His name is Vance Thompson. This is Donald Brown's composition named after his daughter. This is called Daddy's Girl Cynthia.
Thank you.
Got a hand for Josh Peltz on piano. And Andrew Janak on tenor saxophone. You know, you want to talk about important anniversaries. Yesterday would have been the 100th birthday of the great Thelonious Monk. Can you believe that? 100 years. And so we're going to end with a John Fedchock arrangement of a Thelonious Monk classic entitled Epistrophe. Before we do, every year for, 13, 14 years, I forget to mention that Kappa Kappa Psi has a reception in the lower lobby. Every time. I'm not doing that tonight. Now, when you go down there, they're going to think I forgot, and there's probably not going to be anything there. But there's a reception in the lower label, downstairs, plus tax. Kappa Kappa Psi, downstairs, reception. I have proof. Okay. So this is John Fedchock's arrangement of Epistrophe. It's going to feature Jacob Brown on trumpet, Isaac Mitchell on tenor saxophone, Simon Bessemer on alto saxophone, and Malachi Million again on guitar. This is Epistrophe. We'll be right back. Jacob Broad on trumpet. Isaac Mitchell, tenor saxophone. Malachi Million, Simon Bessemer, UNL, Jazz Orchestra.